All right, folks, we've got a juicy scoop here, a bona fide Hollywood insider's tale. It's all about everyone's favorite Californian transplant, Meghan Markle, who reportedly isn't too thrilled about how things are panning out for her in the Golden State. I mean, isn't it always easier to point fingers at everyone else rather than take a good hard look in the mirror? Isn't it easier to say, you're the problem, rather than, maybe it's me? You know what they say, when you point one finger, there are three pointing back at you. Now, what's this? Her royal hubby, Harry, is feeling the pinch in his wallet. Their latest ventures, Harry's book and the next series, didn't exactly bring the royal family to their knees or fill their bank accounts as they'd anticipated. The plan was to shake up the monarchy so much they'd be begging the rebel royals to come back. But as we see, that plot didn't exactly pan out. And the public? Meghan thought they'd flock to them, the progressive rebels ditching the stuffy old royal protocols. But as luck would have it, it seems the fairy tale princess life isn't as easy to maintain when the money tap starts to run dry. Let's face it, once the cash flow slows down, the search for greener pastures begins. However, Hollywood isn't kind to aging actresses, especially those without a steady flow of successful projects. The once desirable roles morph into middle-aged mothers rather than the leading lady spot Meghan imagines herself in. And here's a fun fact for you. Meghan has been signaling to the industry that she's ready for a big movie role, preferably directed by a major name. But the silence has been deafening, not even a peep. Speaking of acting, remember Tyler Perry? You know, the guy who graciously provided the Sussexes with a temporary home in his villa when they first moved stateside? Well, rumor has it Meghan is hoping to use her connection with Oprah to get back in Perry's good graces. Even going so far as to ask him to be the godfather of her child. That's some serious social climbing. But let's be real, Perry isn't likely to be fooled by this. The man is savvy, he's smart, he's dealt with his fair share of Hollywood shenanigans, and he won't be easily led down a garden path. This leaves us with a bit of a conundrum. Why should anyone in Hollywood bother with Meghan Markle? She's got quite a reputation building, and not in a good way. But hey, that's Hollywood for you. Well, here's a thought to ponder on. Can anyone ever make Meghan truly happy? Or is she destined to always find fault, to always yearn for something more? Maybe the charm offensive works at first, but how long until that glitz and glamour start to lose its shine? Meghan's, let's say, challenging disposition could potentially be a serious hurdle. Heck, even Harry might be second-guessing the Grand Californian adventure. Let's not forget the most important characters in this royal saga, their two children. The real question is, how are they faring amidst all this drama? The children of celebrities often bear the brunt of their parents' antics, and it's troubling to think about the potential impact on them. Now, let's talk money, folks. Say Harry decided to leave Meghan. There's no requirement for him to give her assent, regardless of his family's wealth. If his financial situation is as strained as rumors suggest, Meghan's looking at slim pickings. The misconception that all royals are flush with cash is far from the truth. Sure, Harry was born into royalty, but that doesn't mean he's got an endless supply of cash. Other than his military income and royal allowances, Harry hasn't really been a major moneymaker. Don't get me wrong, the monarchy has wealth, but it's not evenly distributed. It's not a pool of money that every member of the royal family can just dip into whenever they please. They get paid for their duties and receive a kind of pension, similar to regular jobs. The real money is in the land and property they own, but again, that's not cash on hand. So, ladies and gents, a word of advice. Don't count on a prince to be your personal ATM. One thing Meghan has been incredibly successful at, it seems, is reinventing her identity to fit her current narrative. She's flip-flopped on her racial identity throughout her life, emphasizing different aspects when it suits her agenda. It's all part of the Meghan Markle enigma, I suppose. So, let's rewind a bit and trace Meghan's journey, shall we? Here's a girl from middle-class America with big dreams of climbing the social ladder. Her first plan of action? Schmoozing her way into the circles of wealthy Middle Eastern elites, all in the hopes of snagging herself a loaded hubby. But they saw right through her, labeled her a gold digger, and that was that. Meghan, however, wasn't one to give up easily. She adjusted her game plan, admitting she dreamed of tying the knot with an Englishman. Lo and behold, who does she end up mingling with but our dear Prince Harry? The prince, well, let's just say he didn't stand a chance against her charm and manipulative ways. For Meghan, it was a jackpot. All she saw were dollar signs and a life steeped in luxury. But here's the kicker, folks. Life ain't a free ride, even for the royals. The question on everyone's mind, is Harry blind or just clueless? His brother William saw through Meghan, as did the Queen. Even Prince Charles had his suspicions. Has Harry been so enamored, so swayed by Meghan that he's lost sight of what's real? What's more, Meghan seems to have a knack for severing ties. She's cut off most of her own family, except her mother, and convinced Harry to do the same, all while acting as though they're just another ordinary couple, which couldn't be further from the truth. One thing that struck me was Meghan's refusal to kiss Harry at the coronation, despite their very public display of affection at a basketball game. Bit of a change of tune, don't you think? Makes you wonder what's really going on behind the scenes. Honestly, this royal drama is like a never-ending soap opera. Seeing the couple maintain their smiles while navigating these turbulent waters is quite the sight. And let's not forget the appalling accusations they've leveled against the royal family, including the late queen, Harry's own grandmother. The audacity, right? But hey, you know what they say, what goes around comes around. So let's just sit back and see how this royal fiasco unfolds. How's this for a plot twist? Despite the uproar they've caused, the couple seems unperturbed, continuing to stoke the fires of controversy. They're not shy about applying pressure wherever they can, trying to squeeze out every bit of privilege they think they're entitled to. But let's get real, folks. What have they actually done to deserve it? The cold, hard truth is, they've shown a distinct lack of humanity and kindness throughout this whole saga. And now it seems they're reaping what they've sown. And what about the invisible children, you ask? Let me put it this way. If they are real, Meghan might have found a new gold mine. Picture this, hefty child support. And if the royal family decides they should be educated in England, Meghan is looking at a steady stream of income. It's a win-win for her. In this grand royal drama, Meghan knows how to play her part. She's going to milk this for all it's worth, portraying herself as the sacrificing mother. After all, she's always the heroine in her own story. In fact, I'd bet my money that Meghan has set herself up nicely for the future. Harry's money seems to be the safety net she was after. And let's not forget her own mother, who, with Harry's financial support, seems to have secured a comfortable life, too. Her estranged father, however, didn't get the same treatment. After raising her, he was promptly discarded. Makes you wonder if Harry's next in line for the same fate. After all, once his money runs out, what's left for Meghan to stick around for? However, Charles being Charles, I don't think he'd let his grandchildren suffer. And Meghan, shrewd as she is, must be counting on this. Well, there you have it, folks. Quite the saga, isn't it? Now, we'd love to hear your thoughts on all this. Don't be shy. Drop a comment below. If you found this interesting, feel free to share it with your friends and family.